Yep, it is definitely autumn, and it's starting to feel a little bit like winter at night already. It's cold out here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Actually heading away from Arts Quest and Steel Stacks. This, believe it or not, this article is not about the Oktoberfest. Instead, it is about the LGBT Wedding Expo that happened at the Fowler Blast Furnace Room, second floor at Arts Quest today. Basically, it was, the Wedding Expo was put on by the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce, and as I almost got hit by a vehicle due to my own stupidity and paying more attention to the article, and the LGBT, I do apologize for it. The LGBT Business Council here in the Lehigh Valley. Now, in case you're wondering, not familiar, Pennsylvania did actually legalize marriage between two people of the same sex. So, yes, we are in 2014. Why this was a huge deal to begin with, beyond my comprehension level, but that's for an editorial. LGBT, in case you're not familiar with the acronym or the initials, stands for lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgendered. Okay? And this was a wedding expo, like I said, sponsored by them. But I got there right at the tail end of it, unfortunately. But everything was still going on. All the vendors were still set up. Check the photos from it on that page. And I really have to tell you that this was just a regular wedding expo. I'm sorry. It didn't focus on any one specific group of people. I mean, I was married for over 8 years. I've been to a couple wedding expos and wedding shows in my life. And I'll tell you what, doesn't matter if you're same sex or opposite sex. This was a flat out regular wedding show and wedding expo. You know, you had a lot of great local vendors in the area, promoting everything from Gail Hoover was there. Basically, if you're getting married and looking to buy your first house or second, third, or whatever, Gail Hoover, real estate was there. Real estate agent was there. They actually gave, to give you a better idea, some of the giveaways were the one airline was gave away a free vacation. The one resort that you could hold your wedding reception or wedding at was giving away a free high-value cake. I think it was the one jeweler, I believe. I might be wrong, and I apologize, but another vendor was giving away $500 off a package. So it was just, this was something where couples, forget about the whole same-sex, different-sex thing, okay? Forget about it. Put it out of your mind. I'm telling you right now. This was a great wedding expo, period. Again, I have the experience. Personal experience. So, yeah, this was something that couples could attend and get a great idea. And also, maybe even some tips on, you know, get some ideas and some tips and some hints and a little bit of help on planning their wedding. I know Valerie Bittner, model, actress, mother, and also she is also a registered minister who was there, and you could book her to perform your wedding. She wasn't the only one. So this was, you know, it was laid out for everyone, okay? I asked someone who from, I believe it was from the Chamber of Commerce, who said, of course the train's going to go by right now. I said, is this going to be an annual event? She said, they are hoping that it does turn into one. I'd place my money on it. You know, like I said, the combination of, I got there right at the end where they were, you know, doing the prizes, and they had, like I said, they, you know, everything you could want to plan your wedding was at this expo. The admission was completely free, by the way. I know most of them are, but you never know. Sometimes you run into where you gotta pay a couple bucks to get in. The admission for this was completely free. The layout and the setup of it was fantastic. They made excellent use of the blast furnace room and outside of it, where there were a lot of vendors and a lot of businesses there, but you still had enough room in the aisles where you could walk two across, not a problem. So the couples could easily approach any table that caught their attention without a problem. Excellent use of the amount of space that they had. I'm hoping that they do this next year, and if they do, hopefully my magazine will seriously approach them to become a media sponsor for this event and promote the living hell out of it, because this is something that's it's great for couples, but it's also something where couples, and here's where I'm going to say the same about the same sex, where couples of the same sex, it's, you know, it's like, okay, guess what? All the prejudice, all the stigmata, all the, you know, everything, you know what? It doesn't exist anymore. You know, hey, we're two men, we're two women, you know what? We're human beings. We love each other. We love each other. And we want to tell the whole world how much we do, and we want to make it official and get married. And you know what? We want to have a fantastic wedding, have all our family and friends there, have a great photographer, a great DJ band, whatever, awesome, and have a kick-ass reception. So this is something that, thank you to the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce. Thank you to the LGBT Business Group. Thank you to Gail Hoover, who I believe she was one of the organizers of this. I could be wrong, but I believe she was one of the organizers also. She, for the first one, you'd swear it was the 10th. Honestly. And I was also actually informed that this became so popular that they actually had to turn businesses and vendors away because there wasn't enough space. So I'd lay money that if you're planning on getting married next year, or in 2016, that I'd lay money, yeah, this is something to keep an eye on for when they make the announcement of that there's going to be another one. If they had that many sponsors, I was told the turnout was at least 200 people. They were going, Oktoberfest was going on, a lot of things going on. They still had a fantastic turnout for this. So yeah, great job. I was impressed with it. And like I said, I was married at one point, and I've been to a couple of these things. You couldn't tell it was the first at all. So, fantastic job to everyone involved on this. You really earned this great review and this great article. Michael Phoenix, founder of the magazine, to everybody out there, thanks for the support. It does mean a hell of a lot to me and the magazine. Be safe in the night and always, no matter where you live. I'll see you around. Later.